Hi friends. As many of you know, I'm a farm girl. I was raised on a farm. I've grown up on a farm. We live on a farm right now. And in those years, I've herded a lot of cows. We've moved cows from the pasture behind our house down to the bottoms. We've moved cows here and there and everywhere to work the cattle and to do all the different things. And one thing that I always had when I was working cattle is that I always had a good stick. And I kept that stick usually posted by the back door so that when I went out to move cows, I had my stick. And it was well fit to my hand. And you know, when you get used to working the cattle and the cattle get used to you, they see that stick and they know that you mean business. And there's a scripture that kind of talks about that, where Saul was out persecuting the Christians and he was going so far against God's will, and he had no idea that that's what he was doing. He thought he was doing the right thing. And he was traveling and he was on the road to Damascus, and God stopped him. And in Acts 26:14, there's this one little section that really hit me this morning. And it says, "We all fell to the ground, and I heard a voice saying to me in Aramaic, 'Saul, Saul, why do you persecute me? It is hard for you to kick against the goads.'" And the goads were basically my stick that I used on the cattle. It's a stick that back during that time, they would make the end of it pointy. I didn't usually have to have a pointy end on mine for the cattle to know that I meant business. But the oxen in the yoke would sometimes need a little encouragement to move in the direction that the farmer wanted to go. They sometimes got a little stiff-necked, and we do too. I know that there was one time in my walk with the Lord when the Lord called me stiff-necked, and I had to do some repenting and get on my face before God. And you know, Paul was going the wrong direction. And very often in life, we get to go in the wrong direction, and God uses a gold, which is a way of showing us that the direction that we're going is not the right direction. And you know, when one of the ways that you know that you're going the wrong direction and you feel God's gold on your life is that everywhere you turn, every direction you turn, there's a pushback, there's pain, there's ineffectiveness, there's walls, there's no fruit to what you're doing. And you know, one of the things that when you are keep coming up against walls is that you need to ask yourself, are you kicking against the direction that God is trying to take you? Very often we are. Now sometimes we do have an enemy that is trying to stop us as well, but there's a very clear difference when you are going against God's will and when you are walking in an enemy attack. And one of the big things that you can do to tell is you look at your life and you look at the fruit. What kind of fruit are you producing in your life? In John 15, verses 8 through 16, Jesus is talking to his disciples, and it says, "This is to my Father's glory that you bear much fruit, showing yourselves to be my disciples." See, there's fruit when we are Jesus' disciples. There should be fruit. And you need to look at yourself and ask yourself, what kind of fruit is my life producing? And Jesus goes on and says, let me see, in verse 14, "You are my friends if you do what I command. I no longer call you servants, because a servant does not know his master's business. Instead, I have called you friends, for everything that I learned from my Father, I have made known to you. You did not choose me, but I chose you and appointed you so that you might go and bear fruit, fruit that will last, and so that whatever you ask in my name, the Father will give you." And see, there's this whole correlation between walking in obedience, following the direction of the Lord, having effectiveness in your prayer life, walking in love, and going the direction that you're supposed to be going. You know, if your life is not bearing fruit for the kingdom of God, you really need to look at the direction that you're going. And if you're facing roadblocks, if you're facing walls, if you're facing pushback, if you're facing pain and ineffectiveness in what you're doing, then you need to ask yourself, am I kicking against the goals? Is God trying to show me what his will is, and I'm struggling and I'm rebelling against that and not wanting to submit to that? It's a good question, folks, and I hope that you will ask yourself that today, because I want you to walk in the fullness and the fruitfulness that God has for you in your life.